Hello everyone, in the previous lecture we have seen how a decimal number can be converted to a binary number or a binary number can be converted to a decimal number. In this lecture we will see the representation of octal number system, representation of hexadecimal number system, how to convert an octal number system into binary number system, how to convert a hexadecimal number system into a binary number system and vice versa. So we know that we discussed in the previous class that an octal number system consists of 8 numbers starting from 0 to 7. So the 0 has an equivalent binary as 000, 1 has an equivalent binary as 001, 2 010, 3 011, 4 100, 5 101, 6 110 and 7 111. Total of 8 numbers are available in octal number system. So basically the grouping is made for 3 number of bits because 2 to the power 3 is equal to 8. That is why we have taken a group of 3. So this is all about octal number system. Now next is hexadecimal number system. So this is a hexadecimal to binary chart. So we discussed in the previous class that a hexadecimal number system consists of 16 digits, 16 numbers. So the 16 numbers are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then the next value is 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. So the digits 10 is represented with the alphabet A. 11 is represented with B, 12 is represented with C, 13 is represented with D, 14 is represented with E, and 15 is represented with alphabet F. So these are the representation of hexadecimal number system starting from 0 to 15. Total of 16 numbers are there. So we can say 2 to the power 4 is equal to 16. That is why we take a group of 4 bits for hexadecimal number system. Let us convert this octal number system into decimal number system. So we know that all octal number system has a base equal to 8 and all decimal number system has a base equal to 10. So any octal number system can be converted to a decimal number system by multiplying that number into the base to the power, the base raised to the power 0, depending on in which place the number is present. So here 7 into 8 to the power 0 is equal to 7. Next, if a hexadecimal number system is given, which is 7, and we need to convert it into decimal number system. So again 7 base 16, 7 into 16 to the power 0, which is equal to 7. So from this we conclude that the decimal value of octal number system 0 to 7 is always equal to the decimal value of hexadecimal number system from 0 to 7, including 0 and 7. So all the numbers from 0 to 7 are included in decimal number system as well as in hexadecimal number system also. Now let us solve few examples. I have an octal number system 1, 2, 3, 4, base is 8, is equal to, let us convert it into binary number system. Now as we discussed that a octal number system always has a group of 3 bits, always has a group of 3 bits. So what we will do, from LSD, this is the least significant digit of octal number system and this is the most significant digit of octal number system. We will write the equivalent binary for these digits. So 4 has a equivalent binary is equal to 100, 3 has a equivalent binary as 011, 2 has a equivalent binary as 010, and 1 has a equivalent binary as 001. Now writing together all these bits will produce the binary number, which is the equivalent binary number of this octal number. So in this way we can convert any octal number system into binary number system. Let us solve few more examples. I have a hexadecimal number system ABC base is 16 and I need to convert this hexadecimal number into binary number. So as we know that hexadecimal number always has a group of 4 bits. So I can say this C has an equivalent binary equal to 1100, B has an equivalent binary equal to 1011, and A has an equivalent binary equal to 1010. And writing together all these bits, we will get this binary number, where this 0 is the LSB and this 1 is the MSB, most significant bit. Now let us convert a binary number into octal number. So the binary number is given as 10110. Now from the LSB, I will start making a group of 3 bits because I need to convert it into the octal number system. So from 0, 1, 1, this is the 3 bit. Next, from 0, 1, we have a deficiency of 1 bit, so I'll put 0 here. So this is my second set. So this particular set has a decimal value equal to 2, has an octal value equal to 2, and this particular set has a octal value equal to 6. So I can say the equivalent octal for this binary is 26. Now let us convert the same binary into hexadecimal number. So 10110 base is 2. Now we know that for a hexadecimal number system, we need to take a group of 4 bits. So start from the LSB, count 4 bits, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 0110. Next, start from here. As I don't have any bit on the left side of this bit, so I'll put 30. So these are my 4 bits. Now the equivalent hexadecimal for this binary is 1 and equivalent hexadecimal for this binary is 6. So 16, base 16 is my hexadecimal number. Now let us convert a binary number which has a binary point into an octal number system. So as we discussed that for an octal number system, I need to take the grouping of 3 bits. So from the left side of the binary point, or for the whole number part, I'll start from LSB and move towards MSB. So I'll take 3 bits, 101. Next 3 bit will be 100. In the same way, for the fractional part, I'll move towards right. So 101, 3 bits, then 100, 3 bits. So the equivalent octal for this 3 bit is 1, and for this 3 bit is 5. 101 has equivalent octal is equal to 5, and 100 has an equivalent octal equal to 4. So this is my octal number. 15.54 is my octal number. Now let us convert the same binary number into hexadecimal number. So for hexadecimal number, we know that I have to take a group of 4 bits for whole number part. So take a group of 4 bits, 1011. Okay, all bits are occupied from LSB to MSB, and for fractional part from left to right. So 1011. So for 1101, the equivalent hexadecimal will be 13, and for 1011, the equivalent hexadecimal will be 11. Now 13 is represented with D and 11 is represented with B. So my hexadecimal will be D dot B. So this is my hexadecimal number. Let us convert a decimal number system into octal number system, as well as a decimal number system into hexadecimal number system. So in the previous lecture, we have seen whenever we need to convert a decimal number system into binary number system, we go on dividing it by 2, and we need to continue the division until we are getting a quotient equal to 0, and after each division I have to record the remainder, and I need to read the whole remainder from bottom to top. In the same way, whenever a decimal number system need to be converted to a octal number system, I need to divide it by 8. So let us perform the division. The decimal number is 35 divided by 8. So 8 4s are 32, the remainder is 3. Read the remainder from bottom to top. So this is 4, 3. Now my equivalent octal number is 43. Now we can perform this operation. We can perform this conversion from decimal to octal by converting a decimal number into binary and again binary into octal. So this 35 decimal can be converted to a binary number system by dividing it by 2. So 2 1s are 2, 2 7s are 14, remainder is 1. 2 8s are 16, the remainder is 1. 2 4s are 8, 0, remainder is 0. 2 2s are 2, the remainder is 0. And 2 1s are 2, the remainder is 0. And write down the remainder from bottom to top. So this is 1 0 0 0 1 1. So this is my equivalent binary of this decimal number system, the decimal 35. Now to convert this binary into octal, I need to take a set of 3 bit from LSB to MSB. So this is the first set 011, this is the second set 100. The equivalent octal for this set will be 4, the equivalent octal for this set will be 3, and my result is 43, which is in octal. So we have seen that a decimal number can be converted to an octal number in two methods. First method, double double method, where I need to divide this decimal by the help of 8 and I need to write down the remainder from bottom to top. Or we can convert this decimal into binary and finally to the octal number system. Now let us see how this decimal 35 can be converted to a hexadecimal number system. So to convert this 35 decimal to hexadecimal, I need to divide this by 2, by 16. So 16, 2 is 32, the remainder is 3. And this is my hexadecimal number, 23. Or we can convert it into binary and finally to the hexadecimal number. So as we have seen that the equivalent binary is 100011, and write down the binary from LSB to MSB. 1100 set of 4 bits, then 0100 set of 4 bits. So this 4 bits has equivalent hexadecimal equal to 2, and this 4 bits has equivalent hexadecimal equal to 3, and this is my result, which is 23. So in this way we can convert an octal number system into decimal or binary, or a binary number system into octal or hexadecimal. Thank you.